Hey guys, in this video I'm going to go over another proof problem. This problem says prove that the limit of n to the 1 over n as n goes to infinity is equal to 1, and it says we may use the inequality n to 1 over n is less than or equal to 1 plus 2 times the square root of 1 over n for all n in the naturals without proof. So for this type of problem we're going to use the squeeze theorem. So let me go over what that is. I did another proof a while ago that also used the squeeze theorem, so it's the same idea, and I will put a link in the description for that video. The squeeze theorem basically says that if you have a function g of x, which is less than or equal to h of x, which is less than or equal to f of x, and then you take the limit of these three inequalities, so the limit of g of x as x goes to infinity, and the limit of h of x and the limit of f of x. If the limit of g of x is equal to the limit f of x, so let's say that's a constant a as x goes to infinity, then that therefore means that the limit of h of x as x goes to infinity has to equal a, because if the limit of g of x is equal to a and it's less than or equal to the limit of h of x, which is less than or equal to the limit of f of x, and the limit of f of x is a, then that means that it has to be greater than or equal to a and less than or equal to a, so it has to be equal to a. So that's basically the squeeze theorem, and we're going to use that in this proof. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. So we are given this hint that helps a lot, that n to 1 over n is less than or equal to 1 plus 2 times 1 over n. So already we can think basically that we need to find the left-hand side and then be able to take the limit of the three parts. And we need a limit that's going to be equal to the limit on the right-hand side. So if we think about it, on the right-hand side, the limit of 1 plus 2 times the square root of 1 over n, that's going to be equal to 1 plus 2 times the square root of the limit of 1 over n as n goes to infinity. So the limit of 1 over n is equal to 0, and probably if you're at that point in a real analysis class, you have proved that that's true. So the square root of 0 is still 0 times 2 is going to be 0. So the limit on the right hand side is going to be equal to 1. So we're going to write that out formally, but right now we're just thinking of what we need to get on the left-hand side. So we need to get something that's going to, the limit of it is going to equal to 1, because that's what the limit on the right-hand side is going to be equal to. So what I did was this. So I said, by assumption, I'm just going to rewrite what we are given, which is that n to the 1 over n is less than or equal to 1 plus 2 times 1 over n for any n in n. Then I said, for any n in n, 0 is less than or equal to 1, which is less than or equal to n. And we're trying to manipulate this statement to look like something is less than or equal to n to the 1 over n. So we're just going to take each base to the 1 over n. So 0 to the 1 over n, less than or equal to 1 to 1 over n, less than or equal to n to the 1 over n. And from this, we can pull out the left-hand side. And so now we have the three-part inequality. So I said, thus we can say, for any n in n, and to pull out the left-hand side, we just need 1, so we can say 1 to the 1 over n is less than or equal to n to 1 over n is less than or equal to 1 plus 2 times the square root of 1 over n. So from here, we now have the inequality sandwiched between two values, and we're just going to apply squeeze theorem and say that the limit of the left-hand side, well, we're going to check that the limit of the left-hand side is equal to the limit of the right-hand side, and then apply squeeze theorem to show that since they're equal, the middle value has to be equal as well. So since the limit of 1 to the 1 over n as n goes to infinity, this goes to 0, so 1 to 0 is going to be 1, and the limit of 1 plus 2 times the square root of 1 over n as n goes to infinity, that equals 1 plus the limit of 2 times 1 over, times the square root of 1 over n as n goes to infinity, which equals 1 plus 2 times the limit of the square root of 1 over n, which is equal to 1 plus 2 times the square root of the limit of 1 over n as n goes to infinity. And we know that this is 0, so that's going to be the square root of 0 times 2 plus 1, which is equal to 1. Okay, so since the limit of 1 to 1 over n is equal to 1, and the limit of 1 plus 2 times the square root root of 1 over n is equal to 1. Now we're going to say by squeeze theorem, we can conclude that the limit of the middle part, which is what we were looking for, n to the 1 over n, as n goes to infinity, is equal to 1. And we're done with this proof.